Jai Hind one and all. The topic we are going to study today is electric dipole. An electric dipole consists of a pair of equal and opposite point charges separated by some small distance. As you can see in the diagram that we are having the equal and opposite charges, point charges we are having, the magnitude is same, the direction is different, and they are separated by a small distance given by 2A. Now, the distance between the charges are taken as 2A, which is already explained, and this distance is known as length of the dipole. Again, I am saying this distance is known as length of the dipole. Now, there is a question in our mind that if the magnitudes are same and the direction is different, then the net charge will be zero. Yes, you are very true. The net charge will be equal to zero, but the net field will never be equal to zero in this case. Now, what do we call and how we will explain the ideal dipole? An ideal dipole is such a dipole which is having almost no size. That means the value of 2A is almost negligible. Again, I am repeating, an ideal dipole is the smallest dipole having almost no size. Moving on to the next topic, that is dipole moment. So, when you are having a dipole, then the measure of the strength of electric dipole is known as dipole moment. When we are going to measure the strength of electric dipole, it will be termed as dipole moment, and it is a vector quantity, as the direction of electric dipole moment is from negative to positive. The formula is given by vector P, which is denoted for electric dipole moment. The formula is vector P is equals to Q into 2A. There is a vector over A. Now for the magnitude, Q mod of 2A. From this formula, we can derive the unit of the electric dipole moment, that is for coulomb for charge and meter for A. That means coulomb meter. Now what is polar molecule? If the center of mass, as we have already studied the center of mass in class 11, so we have a clear concept about the center of mass. The center of mass of positive charge. So we are having the positive charge over here. As you can see, we are having the negative charge over here. If the center of mass of positive charge does not coincide with the center of mass of negative charge, then that combination is known as polar molecule. Then that combination is known as polar molecule, as well as every polar molecule has some permanent dipole moment, because we are having a direction, and that's why, which is directed from negative to positive, we are going to have a permanent dipole moment. The next one is nonpolar molecule. If the center of mass of positive charge, as we have already seen, if the center of mass of positive charge coincides, it matches up with the center of mass of the negative charge, then the molecule behaves as nonpolar molecule. For example, we have O2. So both we have O2. So the center of masses are going to coincide. Suppose we have CO2. For example, we are having CO2. So the atomic number of C is 6. The atomic number of O is 8. So the atomic numbers are very near to each other. Hence, we can say they can act as a nonpolar molecule. Whereas, if we take the example of H2O, example H2O, the atomic number of H is 1, the atomic number of O is 8. So, there is a large gap between the atomic numbers. Hence, they are being termed as nonpolar molecule, as the center of masses is not going to coincide. The next topic we are going to have is dipole field. From the field, electric field, we have already studied the space around the charge is known as electric field. In the similar way, for the case of dipole field, it is the space around the dipole in which electric effect of the dipole can be experienced. We are having a dipole, for example. The field around that dipole, the space charge region around that dipole, will be termed as dipole field. The electric field of the pair of charges at any point can be found from Coulomb's law. Obviously, we are going to use the Coulomb's law. We are going to use the superposition principle to find the dipole field at any point. For the case of dipole field intensity, at any point, we can always imagine a unit charge. As we have already discussed, the unit charge means that a charge which is positive and its magnitude is so small that it is not going to affect the other charges. However, it is going to experience the force due to other charges. We can calculate force on this charge due to each charge of the dipole and take vector sum to get the net value, and which gives us the dipole field intensity at that point.